Welcome to Alex's Guide. Today I'm going to show you guys how to quickly change your brake pads on a 2001 BMW 325i in about 6 minutes. First, start by lifting up your vehicle and placing it on a jack stand. Next, you want to remove the 5 lugs on the wheels. If you don't have an impact gun, it is best to brake the lugs while the wheel is still on the ground prior to lifting it up. This video is not edited, so you're gonna see me finish changing this brake pad in about 6 minutes and less. Next, remove the clip that is on the caliper that's holding onto the caliper and onto the caliper bracket. Use a flathead screwdriver and a hammer and just pop it right out. To remove the caliper, there's going to be 2 plastic cap that's going to cover the bolt for the caliper. There is one on top and one on the bottom. You can either use your hand or you can just use a flathead screwdriver and just pop it right out. To make it easier to remove the caliper, use a large C-clamp and go ahead and compress it. So this will push the piston right in and make it a lot easier to remove the caliper. It is okay to keep compressing it until it bottoms out, until the piston is pushing all the way in. When you compress it, try to keep it as straight as possible because this will prevent the piston from being compressed sideways and prevent damage. To remove the caliper bolt, use a number 7 Allen wrench, or you could also use a hex socket as well. Remember to break it loose, it's always righty tighty, lefty loosey. If you have an impact wrench, this will make the job a lot faster and quicker. If the caliper is stuck, you can use a pry bar to pry it out, or you could also use a big screwdriver as well. If the brake caliper piston is still sticking out, go ahead and use a brake caliper compressor and compress it all the way in. If the new caliper does not go in, you may have to remove it again and compress the piston all the way in again. As you can see here, I'm struggling to get it in, so I know the piston is sticking a little too much. Again, you need to compress it all the way in. Next, make sure you lube the sliding pin. You can either use a brake grease, or you can also use wheel bearing grease. My favorite is actually using wheel bearing grease, and I feel like it works a lot better, and the sliding pin slides a lot better. When installing the sliding pin, make sure you always start with your fingers first. do not start to wrench all the way in, because the frame pin can actually go sideways. If you're using impact wrench, make sure you actually tighten it up with a ratchet. The rest of the video is actually self-explanatory, so I hope you like this video and subscribe to Alex Guide.